Well, should I dance or something? Or
yes.
Say yes.
Hey.
Sounds good.
How are you doing?
All right. Here's to you.
So. Hello, everybody. So you can hear me? Yes. Okay. Well, this little talk is about character and style, and a bit as well as for. Cultural understanding, and it's always a big challenge to put yourself in a position of a different perspective of different cultures, either from client side or from a user's perspective, actually. And this is actually for me a kind of hobby, and it's a kind of game sometimes. And since a certain time, it was my effort to figure out one question which brought me finally to design the Bentley typeface, namely, what is English in modern typography? And however, before I go on to start, I'd like to mention something that although my profession as a designer, I believe whether in just white nor black, it's more the variety on grayscales, which is more interesting. And in English fonts or English typography, it seems to be more the relationship between those two terms, tradition and modernity. It's a well-balanced mixture. They joined nearly in an ideal way together, and that's where probably the reason why I attempt to learn more about this issue. So, tradition and typography, what does it mean? It means more the basic return to traditional values based on a convention or formality, the almost most unchanged kind of writing, reading since 550 years actually, based on a board nib pen. And as an example, how it goes, this font Blado has its roots in the early 1425, and it's based on the letters from the old writing master Arrighi. And this kind of tradition has in England a big historical standing, actually. And modernity means actually the refers to the technological achievements in the 1900s. And it needs to justify a technical way, actually, or like engineers. And this is another example where these those terms come very nicely together, namely in another environment, namely the hop-on buses in London, that you can find nowadays in London streets. I really like the design, and I'm glad they kept actually the older font, namely the it's always I think 100 years old at the moment, and these are the block letters. It became a landmark in the young London city, and a kind of very unique one in our time. So the blocky style have a very geometric character, and in combination with a kind of humanity and humanistic flavor in the lower cases. And there are different variations or interpretations when this font, where these variations are started. In 1923, you have some, and it's I like this. And also, if you see the light, the diamond eye dots or something, it's a very cool spirit, I think. And it's a kind of clarity behind, and there are existing a lot of digitalizations. And the latest one is done last year from the UK team from Nadine Shaheen, and they made up a kind of lower contrast, and it changed the shapes a bit, and modified it. It extended the family up to an hairline, and of course, built it up a bit for web fonts as well. And he's the author, Edward Johnson, and a well-known writing teacher, typographer, and who had published certain teaching books, for instance, writing, illustrating, lettering. And it's believed that this man did assist him during these sketches, the first sketches, his former student Eric Gill. And you see here actually one of the first introduction of the Gill sons as a kind of lettering of the Flying Scotsman in 1928. And its first drawing exists in just in capital letters, the blocky geometric style you see as well. And the lowercase come a couple of years later. And there you see a lot of funny humanism, I think, or a kind of eccentric movement, like the eye dots, and this, it has a kind of personal shape and a kind of sense of humor. And latest, if you see italics, they have a very humanistic flavor in it. And by the way, these sketches, if these sketches of an alternate italic, Gill were actually one of the first who divided or separated italic to Roman itself. He didn't just unclean it like that. And early drawings from the Perpetuum, 1932, that Marx blames also his traditional influence in this font. So, yeah, but there's actually behind, we see kind of very modern sketches. It's kind of engineering a font. It's completely geometric and in its construction. And the glyphs are matching very well together because of the endings, actually. And you see it. Also, the ending, it looks a bit like service, but they are not there, and it makes it very humanistically. And there are a couple of different versions of it, and have a lot of popularity. And nowadays, Gill Sons is actually one of the most working horses in typography worldwide. BBC News in that. These are the street signs of Sydney, which I also really like. And of course, Johnson and Gill supposed to earn a lot of respect of this five typeface, but which did not hold me up to design my own German interpretation of English sans serifs. So, also because I like to learn more about the mixture or about those two terms. So this why Edward actually 2008, 2009 traveled along about towards England, and I put a lot of eccentric style in it, and it's very interesting what to see when you which got going to publish and for what kind of design it's used. It's very surprising for the National Opera in Amsterdam. These are also even for the British Council, they use this as a for posters, and it refers quite a bit to English. And in 2008, KMS team coming up with this question, namely, could Edward possible something be for the new Bentley typeface? At this time, I have been working as a senior designer, and it brought me actually also almost to the knees, because you have to know I grew up in East Germany, and where I just saw Trabant and Wartburg, and it's really, really cool to have this opportunity, actually. But later on, we are going to for a new, completely new design for this company. And however, each design needs strong argumentation, also to convince a high traditional client to leave another high traditional typeface, namely Gil Sans. So for outsiders, it seems to be maybe a bit difficult to convince the client, say, oh, Gil is not good, because it's a good typeface, good legible, but actually this its popularity and DNA is rather a disadvantage for custom corporate fonts in a certain kind of way, special for such special car automotive sector. And a most significant aspect actually were the closest competitor, Rolls-Royce, because for a long period of time, Bentley were just a brand name for slightly modified Rolls-Royce models, or kinds of sports version. They used also Gil Sans, of course, and the car models were almost produced nearly the same way, and so even Rolls-Royce is still using Gil, and so they just wanted to change this. And also, if you see the different X heights, you have to modify a lot of things, and the character were actually not an option to change, actually, and or to modify. You have to do a lot of more things, and it's kind of inflexible. And the good thing is actually we have here a kind of idea of a font, almost not much, but enough to can make a kind of basic, namely the Bentley font name brand. So so then we make a kind of perspective using a chance to create a fresh image for them to and also to show up a kind of perspective how to could be an extending family, and which is quite adaptable for next terms, and also we can guarantee the fixing timing, and that was also very important to because the client were very in hurry. But the essential part were actually the connection with the brand identity, where Bentley has a very strong shape photography and we find some weight with overlapping terms, which means in terms of precision and shape understanding. And Bentley has those kind of decoded power line, and so it's very actually a very nice thing, because we are typographers have always to do with lines and shapes, and it's very quite easy to adapt this. It seems very by the way to find analogies and the characteristic power line. So and show up the control of curves and everything. So that's my actually basic idea, and to create analogies and to show up similar dedication for our products. So yeah, we came up with some sketches first, and built on some nice movements. I really like the diamond dots, and the G is quite unconventional, but they put some idea of it, of the power line, and built up a kind of comparison between the glues. And yeah, so we changed it in a kind of way. Sometimes it went more modern. We brought out a lot of character sometimes, and this is the deal in the comparison. We made it a bit more clear, actually. And the client says, yeah, thanks, except the diamond dots, and but the letter G doesn't look like the same in my computer, so we had to change it, unfortunately. But yes, well, and this was actually the final start, so we were able to reach a certain basic letter point for the extensions, actually. So it's called a typeface now. And it looks rather English. And now it goes to production. I don't want to bore you with a lot of technical details before the launch, but just I want to show up a little bit about regarding to the display font, display version. So we built up kind of capital letter set, put on them lowercase inside, gross numbers, currencies, and actually mathematics, extra signs as well, and did it of course in three poles because of interpolation. And always the shape control is were really important. Yeah, this is a long time ago. I used FontLab at this time. But yeah, and because yeah, it's very important to interpolate them in between. So we built up a kind of master matrix. So the client were able to make a kind of choice, or we were able to make an offer about how could we arrange a kind of family. And so there were the appropriate candidates. And it's important to provide a certain weights in different constellations, so that they were flexible in terms of using, of course. And client were really happy with it. They can't say anything. Ah, okay. And so all the results were designed on a close arrangement with the client, of course, between also the agencies, I have to say, and You made a lot of meetings, and they were able to put some papers on it with some changing things. And so we were ready for the extensions in a kind of mile-free, so-called mile-free format. So when the floating thing around is actually the the so-called tofu, the sign which actually just show up if some glyphs are not there. Interesting is actually client chose the English flag, not the Union Jack. That's really interesting. And so we build up the family, kerning and open type features as well, languages, of course, special capital in punctuation, probably you know this, and superior preview figures, and these were the results. I just so and that's it. No, and now comes the dynamic part, because well, before I go further, I explain shortly parameters, because you have to know in car industries we have to be, always have to be flexible, especially in the OEM part. So we decided to make a kind of 3D interpolation for the client. Before I start, I can show you some things. So you have the shapes, and then it's almost legibility is almost balanced between following parameters. You have the stem with, then you have the counters, and you have the light, left and light side bearings, of course. Both of them are the space between the letters, of course, so they have a word. And for reading tests, you can improve or provide more flexibility by adding more different options per weight. First, to add a wider glyph with the same spacing. And then each of those with a wider spacing, and you can interpolate with them. And this gives you most of kind of flexibility. And this is really important to, for especially for OEM to make a display more working. So we made some tries with the client, and but it wasn't enough, so we built up kind of, we added this principle to another weights, and so we can actually interpolate between all those. And this were actually before the variable fronts happened, but yeah, variable fronts, of course, technology will change everything soon. I think it happens earlier than we expect. And I can show you some experiment I did. And so you can change the weight, of course, and then the spacing between. This will happen very soon, I think. It's really good for display reasons. So we extended the font and built an expanded font, the normal one, italic, of course. And one more thing, of course, the client were finally quite unhappy with the one. So they changed it. They wanted to have a second version of the Mark I, so which are actually just 10 glyphs, but if you have 10 per font by 6, so it's actually 180 glyphs to change. So these are the results now. And it's actually quite still English. It's a bit wider version. And it's more modern. I think it also there's all a lot of German things in it. I know maybe from personality, I don't know. And these are the business cards. I don't have to put the borrow in it. And it, it's really surprising that they just use it firstly the capitals, later than whole text, of course. And these are the first results I saw for 3 or 4 years ago. These are kinds of ones. And but the exciting thing was when the first cards come out, is where the first model, it's a kind of sports car, and if I saw it, I had to look at this thing, and I saw, oh, I can't believe it, they did it, of course. And we're quite happy, and later on, they built a lot of things in the cars, embroideries, stitcheries, imprints and leather and everything. So this is the second version of the, or the first version of the Bentayga. That's really awesome car. And it's just, I've never have seen such a car before. And also here, they build up types, the font, they make it in chrome and everything. And but they built up for themselves. I never were involved in it. And it works quite well, actually. And we just received the models of the buttons. They lasered it in a plastic. And yeah, some impressions of it. And as well, they built up, of course, for display, display fonts and all that stuff. That's quite cool. This is the Fischer version. That's also really fun. And yeah, it's really awesome to see what's happened with a font. If it's gonna to work and to see what it did with it. Yeah. And yeah. So yeah, it's a good to see how it performs and how it's gonna fly. Actually, yes, it wasn't already. Right.